The following program is a Town of Colony television production of the William K. Sanford Town Library.
Welcome to Albany County News. I'm Mary Rozak, the Director of Communications for Albany County. And in the next 30 minutes, we are going to talk about how you can learn more about Albany by getting out of the chair, getting off the couch, and joining Discover Albany and the Albany Visitor Center in all kinds of exciting things that they do for walking tours. Maeve McEnany joins me again. Maeve, welcome back. The Education and Heritage Coordinator at the Albany Visitor Center. And I know that the last time that you were here, we talked about your background and how you are a storyteller and how exciting really it is for you to be able to write your own original walking tours and introduce or reintroduce Albany to people. We talked a little bit about Hamilton.
Yeah.
And how exciting that is. Let's revisit that. Several years ago when you first started at the Visitors Center and you're celebrating your fourth anniversary.
Yeah.
Starting there. Hamilton, huge success.
Yeah.
And so then you had a thought.
Yeah, so it was huge success, but especially because Schuyler Mansion, and Schuyler Mansion is where Hamilton was married, and that's his in-laws' home. Mm-hmm. So the Hamilton fans were seeking it out in droves. But if you've ever been to the mansion, it's beautiful, it's great, but it can only hold so many people. And mm-hmm. so you'd have people coming, and if they couldn't get a tour, they're like, well, what else can I do? So
sure.
We wanted to fill that void of what else you could do.
I know what missed opportunity. Right? So
yeah.
You want to create that opportunity.
Exactly. So Albany Institute of History and Art was the first partner where they created a pop-up Hamilton exhibit. And this year, they are bringing back another Hamilton exhibit about the Schuyler sisters.
Now, what do you mean by, for those who may not understand, because I don't, what is a pop-up exhibit?
So a lot of times with museums, as they should, they have planned years out in advance, right? Because
mm-hmm.
they need to get collections
sure.
and all of that. But every now and again, an opportunity comes up where you need to be quick and nimble. So a pop-up might be something that you are doing up on the fly, right? Something that literally it pops up. You'll also see that concept in restaurants. Is sometimes a restaurant might do a pop-up restaurant where
mm-hmm.
maybe they're
yep.
Trying something out a little new. The Troy Kitchen, I think, is kind of like that, little pop-up restaurants. So it's not the full gallery space. It has
mm-hmm.
its own spot. Diane, who's the curator, is always able to, I don't know how she does it, but she works like crazy to get some really incredible items in these exhibits.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they were able to do a pop-up.
And and that was something they hadn't done before, but now they've become very good at.
Mm-hmm.
Their suffrage exhibit was, anti-suffrage, because it turned out Albany was kind of an anti-suffrage hotbed,
mm-hmm.
but they did that exhibit, and now they can do the Schuyler sisters in that space, which will tie nicely not only with Schuyler Mansion, which of course does Hamilton tours, regular tours, but
mm-hmm.
they have a Schuyler sister tour now as well.
Mm-hmm.
Tenbrook Mansion found their Hamilton connection because Dirk Tenbrook had an appointment with Hamilton and in Jersey, and he unfortunately was at the deathbed, and he wrote back to his father, Abraham, about what he saw, and the letter was sent to the house. So they have a theater company, Creative License, recorded a podcast and recorded that letter by
cool.
a local actor. Albany Rural Cemetery, you can go visit Peggy Schuyler. So you must take the Schuyler tour, of course, but if you miss it, look at all these other opportunities.
And all this happening while Proctor's.
And Proctor's. And Park Playhouse then is doing In the Heights, which is Lin-Manuel's play before he did Hamilton.
Oh,
so that'll
okay.
be their show this summer. So there's really no excuse for you to say, oh, I missed out, oh, I didn't get, there's so many ways to engage.
There's a lot of
yeah.
synergy around that.
Yeah.
But Hamilton is not the only thing that's going on, right?
No.
So there are all kinds of other walking tours. I'd like to say there's a little bit of something for everyone.
Yeah, we've got kids and adults and, for the real history files and those who might be a little nervous about it, so that I say like your less scary, I guess, tours.
Let's talk a little bit about what, first let's get the kids stuff out of the way,
yeah.
right? So if you're a parent and, you know, you want to do something educational but yet fun,
yeah,
right? There's that word that you have to incorporate mm-hmm. in order to make it interesting to the kids. What have you got on tap for them?
So our planetarium shows at the Albany Visitor Center, which is on the corner of Clinton and Broadway, that is every third Saturday.
Okay.
So you can always come and catch a planetarium show, 11 a.m. and 1 p.m., 11 a.m. for our little guys.
Mm-hmm.
I do a walking tour called Wild Tales, and
okay.
you can get more information on albany.org, and that is it's sort of a scavenger hunt where I'm going to tell about some Albany animal history. So we'll talk about Oni from the post office, we'll talk about Henry Hudson's cat, Nipper, but really what it is we'll have these little clipboards and we're looking for carvings, we're looking for examples of animals on our walk, because what I find is that we all get so caught up in our head, you know, not even just our cell phones, but, you know, you and I are having a conversation, we're walking downtown, and nobody thinks to look up.
Okay.
And there are so many treasures in our Albany architecture of animals and faces and all these neat little things. So it's getting kids not only excited to be outside and walking around, and yes, they'll learn a little bit, but also if all they know is they left looking at the former D&H building and remembering the beaver carvings, like, to me, that's a win.
Mm-hmm.
Because we just get so caught up in our own heads, where I want us to be engaged and excited and actively exploring our city.
So are there, when you say look up, do you offer a different look up kind of architecture thing for adults as well?
I should. We have an architecture tour, right?
Okay.
So we do
okay.
have a regular architecture tour that also leaves from the visitor center. And that's when they'll get into the nitty gritty and the styles. So yeah, I would say our tour guide, Hank, if I'm sure he's telling people to look up, because oftentimes Hank and I have done the wild tours together, and we were so surprised, even just as we were training, looking up and what we would find.
Sure. Well, it's interesting, you know, if you're driving sometimes, or you're waiting at a red light, and I'm downtown.
Yeah.
And I look up. That's generally when, you know, your eyes are fixed ahead, or you have time
yeah.
to look around. And I notice the architecture. I mean, it is incredible with the different gargoyles and some of
yeah.
the churches and the things when you really have an opportunity.
Yeah. If
to look.
You have a sunroof, it's like the biggest blessing driving around, because you can look up, you can see all these hidden faces,
mm-hmm.
and it's a good excuse not to text and drive. Right. That red light is not a time to text.
Well, the best excuse for not to text and drive is life. And
well,
fines, right?
True.
You know, but no, that is something else. The let's talk about some of the walking tours though that are geared maybe more towards adults,
yeah,
right?
This one's definitely for the adults. Now, this is the centennial of the passage of Prohibition, you know, that's another theme on albany.org, is we're finding ways to promote Prohibition.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, we started a series of tours with beer historian Craig Gravina,
mm-hmm.
and they're called the Neighborhood Brew Tours,
okay.
because Craig would walk around with me, and he would tell me where the breweries were, why they closed, normally because of Prohibition, and some of the infighting. And we were also walking around neighborhoods that traditionally were not always walking around. People don't think about it as, like, you know, we have downtown maps galore, but nobody thinks to walk around the South End or the Warehouse District looking for these old features, right? These old
mm-hmm.
historic features. So we're kicking them off again, and they're once a month in the summer, and you can get tickets on Eventbrite, but again, albany.org to get that link.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I will say, though, Craig, whenever I talk to him about it, as I say, you know, oh, well these are in, you know, with Prohibition, and he gets like, ah, he says no, because liquor is more a Prohibition story than beer. But I say, well, Craig, why did a lot of the breweries closed? Mostly because of Prohibition. So yeah, so we'll be weaving in that story of Prohibition on his tour. He does dress up. He has a giant top hat and a waistcoat, and we shamelessly go all through Albany and telling these old stories of the breweries and the brewers.
So as I'm thinking about it too, I mean, this is a walking tour, and it really is predominantly downtown.
Yeah, yeah, but that's the thing with the neighborhood tour, is because we have, we'll be in the South End, we'll be in Center
mm-hmm.
Square, Warehouse, and downtown.
Mm-hmm.
But it makes sense, right, because of our access to the river,
yep.
right? And nobody's going to be putting a factory way uptown,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yep.
So a lot of our industry is focused around that riverfront. And as Craig points out, the thing about beer, and we're talking about a history tour, and there's people who are very intimidated, like, well, I don't know that I want to lecture. I don't know
right.
what that means. well, we're starting and ending at pubs. So mm-hmm. people suddenly, that warms them up a little bit to it. But what Craig can do is use that story of beer, and suddenly you're learning about the Erie Canal. Mm-hmm. Suddenly you're learning about Dan O'Connell and the Democratic machine. Mm-hmm. You're learning about Dutch history. And again, it all, and that story changes depending on the neighborhood that we're in, which is why we stretched it out as we did. Mm-hmm. So it's sneaky. It's a little sneak attack. But you still get your beer.
So, but do people really expect that they're going to, when they're going to go on something that's a tour and talk about beer, that it really is prohibition? I mean, I know it's labeled that way, but I wonder if people really, really think that that's what they're going to hear about.
No, I don't think they do. And depending on which neighborhood it's in is where Craig will lean more on it. When we do the downtown tour, because we go by the Kenmore Hotel, mm-hmm. that's where he leans a little more into that prohibition story, because we talk about, you know, Legs Diamond, who was, you know, the bootlegger trying to sneak his way in. Mm-hmm. He could talk about Dan O'Connell and William Kennedy. So it does, it works his way in. He fights me on it, but he works it in.
So you have the flip side. You have prohibition, mm-hmm. and then you have the flip side, a different, you have the pub crawls.
Yep.
That are definitely not about prohibition.
No. Well, again, you know, it's, and that's when we talk about that, it was illegal, you know, and I will talk about that on my tours. Like, at the time, it was illegal in Albany, but Albany was a bit cool to the idea. I mean, that's why mm-hmm. we had speakeasies and, mm-hmm. and all of these things that William Kennedy so wonderfully talks about in his books.
Mm-hmm. So how, when someone goes to albany.org,
yeah.
and they're looking at, when you say you may start at a pub and end at a pub, or mm-hmm. when they're trying to decide what is best for them, what they really yeah. want to do, what advice would you give them when they take a look at the various options?
Yeah, so you can, so if you look at our events calendar on our website, there is so much, right? There's so much to do. There's another link that says Albany Heritage Tourism, and if you click that, we've done different themes like prohibition, literary, Erie Canal, Tastes and Traditions, which is our foodie calendar, mm-hmm. and that can narrow it down that way as well. But if you are so overwhelmed, you can always call us at 434-0405, and our front line staff, that's one of the first things that we're trained in, is to say, if a visitor asks you, what can I do, we say, what do you like to do? Mm-hmm. So we keep giving you our website, but call the visitor center, talk to us, because our frontline staff, I mean, that's their job. That's my job. What do you like to do?
Sure.
And we'll find something.
Sure. Talking with Maeve McEnany from the Albany Visitor Center and Discover Albany. You see thousands of people every year.
Yeah.
Is there something, a common question that gets
Ooh,
asked?
Ooh, that's a great question. You know, a lot of it has to do, you know what, I would say parking. You know, you get a lot of questions about the parking. You and I talked about that in the last segment. And, you know, Visitor Center is a great place for that. And we recommend looking at Park Albany's website. There's even an app now, which is really great. So that can be intimidating to people. They say, well, I want to come and visit, but where can I park? Mm-hmm. People aren't going to believe me. There is parking. We know where the parking is. Don't be afraid to call us. We get a lot of questions about the New York State Capitol building, about exploring that space there in the plaza and what to do. And family programming, you know, that's a really big draw, is people want to know what to do with their kids.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it can run the gamut. But yeah, I would say that parking, because people get a little nervous when they're coming into the city.
Sure.
And we have the reputation that there is no parking. And don't worry, there is, but sometimes you do have to ask an expert, and we can be the expert.
And nights and weekends, as a reminder, the parking, the meters are not in force.
Right.
So people can easily park on the street.
Exactly.
Okay. Let's talk about some of the other tours that that we've talked about. You mentioned literary. Let's talk about the Albany, the library
theme.
Yeah.
So this was a passion project for me. My degree is in, master's degrees in English literature. And, we have a great system in Albany where we actually have meetings with all of our heritage sites and friends and we try to come up with themes for the year. And I said, for literary, maybe we could do a month. And they said, no, let's do a year, because every museum has letters and things like that. And I partner with the Albany Public Library, and we do a literary pub crawl in June during Path Through History Weekend. And we start at the library, and they've pulled out a lot of different Albany authors. And then I walk us downtown. Yes, we go to pubs, but I read passages from local authors. I talk about famous authors like Charles Dickens and Oscar Wilde, who came through Albany, if they had any opinions on that. And it continues to grow, because I keep finding and hearing about more and more authors coming through. So that's probably one of my favorite. That's my passion project tour. I love that one. So.
What are some of the other tours? I know you have something that's huge when it comes to scary.
Oh, yeah.
And that, of course, in October. Let's talk about that.
I've been doing ghost tours for over 10 years, and now I kind of do them wherever I'm asked. We do Erie Albany out of the Visitor Center. We do the pub crawl, another pub crawl. Yeah, that's not a brand.
We have a lot of pubs, though.
We have a lot of pubs.
People enjoy that.
That we partner with Tenbrook Mansion and Historic Albany Foundation, and that is in the supposedly haunted Tenbrook Mansion in October's, which is great. And in fact, it even inspired my my brother John, who's in New York City, and he is also a playwright. And so he wrote an original play about the Lincoln Dress, which was the home in Loudonville that the Clara Rathbone was wearing, was there, a Loudonville woman living, went to go see the show with Lincoln, and she was there when he was assassinated. And so she walled the dress up in the home in Loudonville, the Loudon Cottage, and supposedly the spirit is drawn there.
Wow.
Now, he wrote an original play that's going to be performed at Siena College before it goes on to Romania. So that'll be also in June.
Wow.
So it's, it's kind of neat how it's been inspired. Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. That is interesting. Are you always in awe? Is there something that you seem to find out new, or a little fact about something, constantly, even though you've been doing this for so many years?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it would be totally boring if you didn't.
Sure.
And, and my father, the local historian, Jack, he says that all the time, he does genealogy because he says it's the poor man's treasure hunt. And, we're always finding out new and fun, and the great thing about my position at Discover Albany is that I have met way better historians than I will ever be, and they like me, which is nice, so they tell me things all the time, and I'm able to link them up with a lot of these historic sites to give them that chance to tell that story.
Sure.
It's wonderful. It's a great job.
Well, it's got to be interesting. When we were talking about Hamilton, you brought in that that you're doing the tour with Matt Millett.
Yeah.
And Matt has gotten some notoriety of late with some baseball.
Yeah.
History. Has there been discussion maybe with him about maybe doing any kind of tour, any kind of something like that, incorporating that new information with the, the first home run?
First Grand Slam. Yeah, I've seen him give the lecture before. Long ago, it wasn't my script, but the Albany Aqueducts did have a baseball tour. It would be interesting if I dug that old script up somewhere and tie him in to do that. Maybe. That would be pretty good.
That would be, interesting, considering that now Albany really is becoming the hub for women's sports. I know we've got
the Aurora Games.
The Aurora Games coming in August. We've the inaugural Aurora Games coming in August. And when we take a look at all of the NCAA women's basketball and the history that we've had here, that may be something.
I know. File that. As we said in the last segment, how do you come up with your ideas? I steal. Other people tell me.
You steal that one. But you said you've been, it's interesting, you've been bringing more people in and helping with some of the guided tours, and it adds another layer.
Yeah. I've been finding more satisfaction in the past couple of years giving to other people and watching them do it. Mm-hmm. So with the ghost tour that we do with Tenbrook Mansion at in October, it got too big, and also I've been doing this tours for 10 years, how many times can people, and I have repeat visitors,
sure.
But you know, there's another dimension that comes in when you bring in someone who has another focus or another interest. One of the tour guides works also at Schuyler Mansion, and mm-hmm. so she has some wonderful stories, and she pulls in a little colonial aspect, and she dresses up. So, you know, we've got the Lincoln historian. I actually think it's going to be something that we're going to market stronger next year, because we had so many people who took the pub crawl last year who said, I really like this, but if I take it next year, will I get someone new? Mm-hmm. And we said, well, yeah, we can ask. So I'm finding there's a lot more strength in bringing more people in. The way I describe it, it's like the sandbox, where if I'm in the sandbox and I have the ball mm-hmm. and I'm not playing with anyone, it's not fun. When
sure.
it's fun is when I pass the ball, right? And, then,
right.
and
yep.
that's when
and
it's
you
fun.
Get more, yeah. Yes. And speaking of that, you know, so Paul Grondahl, yeah. the Writers Institute, I know that we talked about previously the Moby Dick Club, which I will mess this up. It's yep. White Whale Wednesdays.
There you go.
Oh,
yeah.
my goodness.
And we drink Melville Wit that the Albany Pump Station brewed special for us.
And you talk about 100 pages each week
yes.
of Moby Dick.
Yes.
So Paul Grondahl was involved. I know that you talked
yeah.
about that. But the Writers Institute is also involved. There's a book fair that's going to be
yeah,
happening
in September.
Well.
There's going to be this. They did it last year, and they had 4,000 people who came to UAlbany's campus.
Okay.
And they had, I mean, it was a huge convention. I mean, I went. I didn't know what to expect, but they had mm-hmm. Doris Kearns Goodwin.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Gregory Maguire, who's also from Albany, and he's a UAlbany graduate. He wrote Wicked. He spoke. Of course, you had William Kennedy, our Albany son.
Sure.
And he spoke, and it was, so you had lectures, but then you also had breakout sessions going on at the same time about history writers and food writers, and that was great. And then there were vendors, and there was a kids section. And so they say, I mean, this was pretty great out the door, but they say they're going to make it bigger and better this year.
Wow.
So,
and they had 4,000 last year.
Oh, I don't know how they're going to do it, but it was probably one of my favorite events that I attended last year, so I'm really excited. And they say possibly that they might do a little send-up for our White Whale Wednesdays, so you still have time to join us. For mm-hmm. at I believe it's every second Wednesday at the Albany Pump Station, 100 pages.
But albany.org is the place you need to.
And albany.org, yeah, because otherwise I'll give you too much information. You'll be like, albany.org.
And they can figure it out.
Yeah.
Tentbrook Mansion.
Yeah.
Also doing something else, producing Turn of the Screw.
Turn of the Screw. And it's another spooky ghost story. So Henry James, he's mostly known for Portrait of a Lady.
Right.
And but he wrote this very strange ghost story called Turn of the Screw. It was turned into a movie called The Innocents. And but the thing is, because they're the Albany County Historical Association at Tenbrook, I said to them, you know, James has a local connection. His family was from Albany. His family actually has a plot at Albany Rural Cemetery.
Hmm.
There's thoughts that one of the women buried there is who the main character of Portrait of a Lady is based off of.
Oh, really?
There's a little star, and they say that James, the author, said, oh, that's my little star, and he designed it, right? So there's a great literary connection. But then this is me, the ghost tour lady. Henry James's brother, William James, started one of the first the psychic societies in the United States.
Really?
And I said, there's got to be a way that these brothers, like, he's writing a ghost story.
Sure.
And, you know, so, and I haven't teased that one out yet. I'm still doing research on that one.
Mm-hmm.
But the Creative License, who is a local theater company, loved the idea, and so they're going to be producing a play in October, just before those pub crawls. And Tenbrook has been doing pretty great work on doing theater in that site, so, and it sells out real quick. So they haven't announced dates yet and ticket sales, but yeah, albany.org. And
you'll have that up there as soon as...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's going to be a really exciting one.
Well, then give us some insider information here. Insider information is okay. It's no crime to tell us about things that are coming up.
That's good. Yeah, that's what I like.
what else do you know that you can give us a little tip on that we should be looking for that may be coming up, other events?
Oh, I would say a lot of, check out the Writers Institute. The Writers Institute has been really pretty wonderful about going out into the community more and more and getting a lot of different and diverse speakers. I think they're doing some great stuff. I can probably tease that in 2020, there might be a more environmental theme going on. So we've done literary, we've done Hamilton, Prohibition, right? Mm-hmm. We've done all of this, but what about our science museums, right? So they've been coming and they've been participating, and they're like, but I thought, well, they have such wonderful resources as well. So something about the environment, but that also pulls in the gardens that many of our sites have.
Okay.
So that's what I think is kind of cooking up right now. So,
okay.
TBA.
Okay. We just recently had the Tulip Festival, which I can say, because as this is airing, we know we're past that. Is there anything where you do guided tours or anything with the flowers and the history and all of that in Albany?
So the city of Albany has Jess Morgan, the city gardener, who's so dynamic and so cool. And so she does tulip tours, and I think it's just a phone call if she's available. Her summer plants, people forget how great the summer plants are. They're tall and they're wild. So she does those sort of plants. But I did a tour today based on the book Winter Sisters, which is it's a story that takes place in Albany, and I had a group call and said, can you show us the sites? And it happened to be the tulips were still in bloom, and I just stopped. We were on a bus. We stopped, and we got out.
Oh,
so
wow.
I'll admit what I do. I work that Moses statue in no matter what. If you get me on a bus tour, no matter what I'm talking about, if I'm on a bus, we're at the Moses statue, and the flowers, whether it's spring or summer's in bloom, I'm hopping out and I'm going to give you a tour there.
Well, that's good to know. And how often do you actually get calls to do special tours like that?
It's starting, I don't know, some secret came out maybe on your show, is I've been getting more and more calls for those. So often in May, we'll get them, and then we'll look to October, we'll get some more there. But I'm finding, I don't know, if you ask me that question next season, I think it's going to be even more. I've been getting a lot.
It sounds like it's pretty simple. So go to albany.org to find out about what is existing.
Yep.
The phone number's on there to call. You can call and ask any kinds of questions. What do you like most about any of the tours or any of the educational components that you're involved with?
Everyone is different. So I may be relaying the same information. My audience is different, whether it's the school kids, whether it's travelers from all over the world. I'm never bored, because every person I meet is new, is different. They have their own stories. So a lot of people say, well, how can you say the same thing over and over again? I'm like, well, I don't, because my audience is different, and they give me something different every single time.
How far in advance does someone need to book a reservation, or can somebody actually just walk up to the stand and do that?
Most of them, the planetarium, you don't need a reservation. The brew tours, I would recommend a reservation. Any of the other ones, you can just walk up. I would say if you see a tour and it says the word pub crawl, those, funny enough, tend to sell
probably
pretty quick.
Book it right away.
Yeah.
Right? And everything is reasonable when it comes to cost.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Between $3 and $5. Pub crawls might be a little more, but otherwise it's $3 to $5.
Wonderful. So Maeve, as always, you've been very informative and given me a lot to think about. Many others, I think, because all you have to do is, it's very simple. You're getting information. You're telling a story.
Yeah.
So you're entertaining, and people are getting great exercise.
That's great. That's what I like to hear.
And I don't think that people think about that. So you've got the trifecta going on. And I'll be anxious to hear about what you do with Matt Millett, and maybe some sport, sure, something sports-wise.
All right. I'll give him a nudge.
He'll hear this, and he'll be jumping on it. But thank you very much. We've been visiting with Maeve McEnany from the Albany Visitors Center and Discover Albany. I'm Mary Rozak, the Director of Communications for Albany County. You've been watching Albany County News. We'll see you again soon.